going to do is we're going to stick it into something that models the blood capillary. And that is this stuff here called visking tubing. Now, visking tubing, you need to soak it in water to be able to use it. Very often I've seen students trying to use the dry stuff. It comes like just like plastic on a roll, really. But if you soak it in water and then you give it a little rub, what you'll find is that one end opens really, really easily. So at the other end, I'm going to tie a knot in this. This is why you need a fairly long piece. Tie a knot in that. I'm going to try and move the knot as long, as close to the end as possible. And continue to rub that bit there. And then I'm going to use a pipette. And I'm going to move some of this blood plasma into here. And that's about enough. It's a nice long piece of visking tubing, so I'm going to tie a knot in the top of that. Now I'm testing whether the glucose will move out of there or whether the protein will move out. So I need to rinse the outside of that to make sure that it's free from residues of protein or glucose. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop it inside a bullion tube. And I'm now going to fill that up with water so it's fully submerged in there. Now you can just leave that in a bullion tube and leave that diffusion to happen. Or because I've got my hot water bath on anyway, I'm going to place it in the hot water bath because that will just speed up the kinetic movement, the motion of the particles, because they've suddenly got more energy. They're going to move more and diffusion is going to happen a little bit quicker. Mop up any spillages. Okay, and in the meantime, of course, what I need to do is make sure that my blood plasma does contain protein and it does contain glucose, because then I can compare it to the filtrate that is the water surrounding it. So to do that, I'm going to take a couple of boiling tubes, and the test for protein is really, really simple. All we need to do is literally take a drop. I can work in really small quantities. Place it in the bottom there, teeny tiny drop. I'm going to take some of my BioRet reagent, which is normally blue, and I'm going to add that. And it should turn purple, and indeed, there it is, it's turned a nice purple colour. Reagent. This will change to a brick red colour for a positive result. In other words, it'll turn to like a really sort of dark red colour if I've got glucose in here, which I do expect to find. I'm going to add an equal quantity, give it a shake, and then I'm going to put it in a really hot water bath for about 5 minutes. Okay, so I've retrieved my boiling tube, which had water and the blood plasma in the visking tubing. I'm going to take that out and remove that. And then I'm going to use a pipette to remove some of this into two more boiling tubes. I only need small quantities. That leaves me some left, so that if I want to repeat my experiment, which makes my results more reliable, I can do. So I'm going to pop that there. Okay, I'm going to label this now. I'm going to label one for protein, so I don't get mixed up, and I'm going to label one for the presence of glucose, or reducing sugars. Glucose is a type of reducing sugar. In this one, I'm going to add some BioRet solution, because of course that's the thing that tests the protein. Again, just a few drops in there. And give it a shake. I'm hoping to see that it won't change colour. And it hasn't. And that's because the protein has been too large to pass through small holes in this visking tubing. In this one, I've tested the glucose, so I'm going to use my Benedict's reagent. This is going to be a little bit of a longer test. I now need to place that in a hot water bath for about 5 minutes and see if there's any colour change. I've just retrieved the blood plasma that I was testing for the presence of glucose. Again, I expected to find glucose in there, and indeed I have. Now, when Benedict's changes colour, it goes through various stages of colour change. It goes through green and yellow and orange. So I'm going to pop that back in because I'm not entirely sure it's finished changing colour just yet. But you can see it's already taking on that orange sort of brick red, they call it, colour. the water bath, and you can see it's turned to what we call a brick red colour. Now, to observe colour changes, it's often good to do it against a white background. Just a few important things to note about this experiment. You need to be really careful that you don't cross-contaminate. And what I mean by this is that your boiler tubes are rinsed, that they don't contain residues of glucose when they're not meant to, or protein, for example, and that you don't cross-contaminate with PETs also.
And filtering that red brick result, what we're going to find is a precipitate. There you can see it's left in the boiling tube, and if we filter it, you'll find teeny tiny particles left behind, which we call a precipitate. A precipitate is when two liquids mix together and form a solid.